فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
So الإمام الدارقطني went on to saying, حدثنا أحمد بن محمد بن سليمان. أحمد بن محمد بن سليمان, we took his ترجمة, his biography. He said, حدثنا عمر بن شبة. We took who عمر بن شبة is. حدثنا أبو عاصم. His name is ضحاك بن مخلد. حافظ ثقة من رجال التهذيب. عن سفيان. So if you look, Abu Asim is narrating from Sufyan al-Thawri, whereas the narrations before, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan was the one that was narrating from who? It was narrated from Sufyan al-Thawri. So that's the reason why the author wants to bring this narration. He wants to prove that not only did Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, the great Hafiz al-Mutqin, was not the only one who narrated from him. Rather, Abu Asim, Dhahak ibn Makhladin also narrated from him. He was on Hafiz al-Mutqin. An Sufyan al-Thawri, he narrated from Sufyan al-Thawri. An Mansur, an Ibrahim, an Abidata. Now here, we have Mansur narrating from who? Ibrahim al-Nakha'i. We also had before Sulaiman narrating from Ibrahim al-Nakha'i. Sulaiman here, Sulaiman ibn Mihran al-A'mash. Narrating from who? An Ibrahim al-Nakha'i, an Abidata. Are you with me, brothers? Those are the narrations that the author mentions. How many people did he mention narrating from Ibrahim al-Nakha'i? He mentions Mansur and he mentions Sulaiman. There are also other narrators which he hasn't mentioned, which Al-Imam al-Tabarani brings in Kitab, in his Mu'jam al-Kabir. Min tariq Abi Hisham, and Ibn Abi Asim brings in Kitab al-Sunnah, min tariq Abu Mahyat. All of those two have narrated min tariqi from through an Ibrahim al-Nakha'i, an Abidata al-Salamani, an Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, may Allah be pleased with him. He says that a man came min ahli al-kitab, from the people of the scripture. And we took on the previous narration that the man who came was one, a Jew, and second, that he was a habr. He was a man of knowledge from the people of the Jews. Ila Rasulillah, came to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, faqala, and he said, inna Allah azza wa jalla yad'u as-samawati ala usbu'in. Allah places the samawat on a finger. Wal aradina ala usbu'in. And Allah places the earth on a finger. Wal jibala wa thara ala usbu'in. The mountains and the land on a finger. Wal shajara, the tree. Wal ma'a, and the water. Ala usbu'in, on a finger. Wal khala'iqa ala usbu'in. And the creation on a finger. Thumma yaqulu, and then Allah will say, anal maliku. That shows that can't be a human being's finger. Or it can't be a creation. Because you know what they say? They say usbu' is an alam. Instead of a sifa, they say it's an alam. It's a name of a creation. Kayf? They say it's a name of a creation. Allah creates, subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can that creation say, anal maliku, the day of judgment? Anal maliku. He can't say that. Only Allah can say that, subhanahu wa ta'ala. فضحك رسول الله, the messenger laughed, حتى بدت نواجده, until his molar teeth showed, عليه الصلاة والسلام. ثم قرأ, and then the messenger recited, وما قدر الله حق قدره والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيمينه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. You can read it as, or if you want to read it, قراءة حمز and كسائي, and was the اختيار of أبو عبيد, is that you can read it, تعالى عما تشركون with it. And we spoke about that and we mentioned that in our previous session and our previous points we were talking about. Here, inshallah ta'ala, this ayah, وَمَا قَدَّرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Let's take a call said by Imam al-Mufassirin, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, on the commentary of this verse, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, on the tafsir of this verse, he said the following. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he brought the ayah, وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ. After he brought, Ibn Jarir brings all of the adilla that we just brought, the narrations and the turuq and the hadith and whatnot, the Jew man who came to the Prophet and everything, he brings it. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. And then after that, he says the following. He says, وَقَالَ بَعْضُ أَهْلِ الْعَرَبِيَّةِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبَصْرَةِ. He said, some of the people of the language, أَهْلُ اللُّغَةِ, أَهْلُ الْعَرَبِيَّةِ, the people of the Arabic language, who knew the Arabic language, مِنْ أَهْلِ الْبَصْرَةِ, but from the people of Basra. They said, وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. They said, فِي قُدْرَتِهِ, in Allah's ability. So they said, بِيَمِينِهِ, it means in Allah تبارك وتعالى's ability. يَقُولُ فِي قُدْرَتِهِ نَحْوُ قَوْلِهِ, like the statement of Allah. They said, it's exactly the statement of Allah, which Allah says, وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ أي وَمَا كَانَتْ لَكُمْ عَلَيْهِ قُدْرَةٌ. They said this verse, وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. He says, they said that it's ability. Okay? أهل العربية من أهل البصرة saying this. And they said it is like قوله تعالى, the statement of Allah, وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ, that which your right hand has possessed. They said, أي, it means, أهل البصرة saying this, وَمَا كَانَتْ لَكُمْ عَلَيْهِ قُدْرَةٌ, anything which you have strength over it and power over it. Then Ibn Jarir al-Tabari refutes them. And he says, وَلَيْسَ الْمُلْكُ لِلْيَمِينِ دُونَ سَائِرِ الْجَسَدِ. كيف? How can that be? He said, how? Because I said, what does I say? وَمَا مَلَكَتْ وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ, right? Ibn Jarir says, وَلَيْسَ الْمُلْكُ لِلْيَمِينِ, the right hand, what it possesses. Are you with me? Sorry, وَلَيْسَ الْمُلْكُ, the ownership is not for the right, دُونَ سَائِرِ الْجَسَدِ, besides the other parts of your body. So if you say, وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ أَمَا وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ, if you say بِيَمِينِهِ here means بِقُدْرَتِهِ, he says that the قُدْرَ restricted only on the right side, on your right, over the rest of the body. And the Arabs, they don't use يَد as قُدْرَ, and it's restricted to the يَمِين. Impossible. Are you with me, brothers? Are we saying it? قال وقوله قبضته والسماوات مطويات بيمين. What do you say? والأرض جميعا قبضته, right? قبضته وقوله قبضته. And they said Allah is grabbing. نحو قولك للرجل. أهل البصرة are saying, it's like your statement that you say, هذا في يدك وفي قبضتك. They said this means that this person is in your hand. This person is in your hand, or is in your qabda, he's in your grab or your fist, right? So they said that's what it means. It doesn't mean necessarily Allah is grabbing them. It means that so and so is in your is under your control. It doesn't mean you have a hand that you're holding them down on. This is all the Ahlul Arabiyyati min Ahlul Basra, what they say. Look what he does then after that. He says, والأخبار, look at Wallah ibn Jarir al-Tabari. He says, والأخبار التي ذكرناها عن رسول الله, the narrations that we brought from the messenger. Are you with me, brothers? Which is all the narration that we just brought right now. It's all the narrations that we brought right now. Ibn Jarir said, all those narrations that we brought. And I'm using it for the last narration here, because we brought all those narrations, right? Or we brought a good portion of it. والأخبار التي ذكرناها, the narrations that we mentioned. عن رسول الله, from the messenger of Allah, وعن أصحابه, and his companions, وغيرهم, and other than them, تشهد على بطول هذا القول. It shows the falsehoodness and that the statement of these in أهل العربية من أهل البصرة, that it's null and void, that it is not correct. The Imam al-Mufassirin, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, is refusing to call Allah's hand Qudra. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, Imam al-Mufassirin, you see. Let's look at Al-Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah. Al-Imam At-Tirmidhi rahimahullah ta'ala. This book is Sunan At-Tirmidhi, which is known as, is called as well, Al-Jam'u Al-Kabir, written by Al-Imam Abi Isa Muhammad ibn Isa ibn Sawrah At-Tirmidhi, who died in the year 279. Ibn Imam al-Tirmidhi, if you look at the kitab, this is the best taba'ah, by the way. This taba'ah is called Daru Ta'asil. It's the best taba'ah, alhamdulillah, that's out there now. It's the best taba'ah. If you go to the kitab, Babu Maja'a Fi Fadli Sadaqah, the chapter is called Babu ma jaa fi fadli sadaqah. Are you with me, brothers? The book, Sunan Tirmidhi, has many books inside it, right? The book inside it is called Babu. Huh? Is it Babu or is it Kitabu ma jaa fi sadaqah? I think it's Babu ma jaa fi sadaqah. Let me check. Naam. Sorry, it's Bab. It's a chapter. It's not a Kitab. It's not the book. It's Babu ma jaa fi fadli sadaqah. He brings it in the chapter where it's what? Babu ma jaa fi fadli sadaqah. Are you with me, brothers? It's hadith number 666. Dar al-Ta'seel. To be more precise, if you have Dar al-Ta'seel, you can go to the second volume. You can go to the second volume. Page 99. Look what he does after he brings the hadith where he says, حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو قُرَيْمُ مُحَمَّدِ بْنُ الْعَلَىٰ is. قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا وَكِيعُ بْنُ جَرَّاحَ الرُّؤَاسِ is. قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا عَبَّادِ بْنُ مَنْصُورٍ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا الْقَاسِمُ بْنُ مُحَمَّدٍ قَالَ سَمِعْتُ أَبَا هُرَيْرَةَ يَقُولُ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إن الله يقبل الصدقة ويأخذها بيمينه فيربيها لأحدكم كما يربي أحدكم مهرته أما كما يربي أحدكم أما أحدكم مهره حتى إن اللقمة لتصير مثل أحد وتصديق ذلك في كتاب الله هو يقبل التوبة عن عباده ويأخذ الصدقات ويمحق الله الربا ويربي الصدقات قال عيسى أبو عيسى الترمذي هذا حديث صحيح وقد روي عن عائشة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نحو هذا. Here's what I want. Pay attention to this now. I can't translate everything because it's too long. But what the benefits and Imam al-Tirmidhi's Sunan has, and the virtues and the benefits in this book is that. And Imam al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah, what he does is sometimes he mentions the narrations and he does a little ta'liq on it. He might even go to the ilal and then little, you know, Tirmidhi, rahimahullah. And he has that nu' min al-nafas. He goes a bit in. And Imam al-Tirmidhi, fawaid that you get. So what he does is, he speaks for like half a page. He says, because this hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ التَّوْبَةَ Allah accept, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ الصَّدَقَ Allah accepts the sadaqah. وَيَأْخُذُهَا And Allah takes it بِيَمِينِهِ with his right. This is the narration that Imam al-Tirmidhi brings. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ الصَّدَقَةَ وَيَأْخُذُهَا بِيَمِينِهِ Are you with me? Pay attention. So here, بِيَمِينِهِ is, what does it fall under? It falls under hadith al-sifat. The hadith which speak about Allah Taala's characteristics. Alaysa kadhalik? Isn't that the case? Naam. So Imam al-Tirmidhi now, he wants to speak about this issue of hadith al-sifat, ayat al-sifat. How should we deal with it? He says, وَقَدْ قَالَ غَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ فِي هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ وَمَا يُشْبِهُ هَذَا مِنَ الرِّوَايَاتِ مِنَ الصِّفَاتِ وَنُزُولِ الرَّبِّ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا قالوا قد ثبتت الروايات في هذا ويؤمن بها ولا يتوهم ولا يقال كيف هكذا روي عن مالك بن أنس وسفيان بن عيينة وعبد الله بن مبارك أنهم قالوا في هذه الأحاديث أمروها بلا كيف وهكذا قول أهل العلم من أهل السنة والجماعة وأما الجهمية فأنكرت هذه الروايات وقالوا هذا تشبيه وقد ذكر الله تبارك وتعالى في غير موضع من كتابه اليد والسمع والبصر فتأولت الجهمية هذه الآيات وفسروها على غير ما فسر أهل العلم وقالوا إن الله لم يخلق آدم بيده وقالوا إن معنى اليد ها هنا القوة وقال إسحاق بن إبراهيم إنما يكون التشبيه إذا قال يد كيد أو مثل يد أو سمع كسمع أو مثل سمع فإذا قال سمع كسمع أو مثل سمع فهذا التشبيه وأما إذا قال كما قال الله تعالى يد وسمع وبصر ولا يقول كيف ولا يقول مثل سمع ولا كسمع فهذا لا يكون تشبيها وهو كما قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير. الإمام الترمذي mentions durar gems here, gems. We get his speech is divided into two or three. He mentions the mu'attila, he mentions the mushabbiha, and he mentions Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'a, their mawqif and their position regarding this. He says, وَقَدْ قَالَ غَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ مِنْ فِي هَذَا So from here, until where I stop, this is going to be Ahlul Hadith, Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'a, their position. What did they say? وَقَالَ غَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ فِي هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ More than one people of knowledge from Ahlul Hadith, Ahlul Ilm, Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. They said, وَمَا يُشْبِهُ هَذَا مِنَ الرِّوَايَةِ مِنَ الصِّفَاتِ وَنُزُولِ الرَّبِّ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى كُلَّ لَيْلَةِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. What did they say? قَالُوا قَثَبَتَتِ الرِّوَايَاتُ. Their response was, these narrations are transmitted to us authentically. فِي هَذَا وَيُؤْمَنُ بِهَا وَلَا يُتَوَهَّمْ. It's believed in it. We take it on. And there's no speculations or wahm regarding it. وَلَا يُقَالُ. No one can say كَيْفَ how. هَكَذَا رُوِيَ عَمْ مَالِكِ بْنُ أَنَسٍ. Like that, Imam Malik said it. وسفيان بن عيينة said it. وعبد الله بن المبارك said it. أنهم قالوا في هذه الأحاديث, they all said about this hadith, أمروها بلا كيف, go over it without any how. What does it mean, go over it as it is? Affirm it. Don't try to give it a meaning. Don't try to distort it. Leave it the way it is. Affirm it the way it is. Go over it the way it is. بلا كيف, without any how. And that meaning, we explained it inshallah ta'ala in the muqaddimah, remember when we were talking about it. وهكذا قول أهل العلم من أهل السنة والجماعة. That's the قول of أهل السنة والجماعة. أمروها بلا كيف. Did Allah say he has a hand? I affirm a hand for him. This is the characteristic of his. I affirm it. I'm not gonna try to give a meaning to it. I'm not gonna try to distort it. I'm gonna say Allah has a hand that befits His Majesty. سبحانه وتعالى. بلا كيف without a how. Are you with me? Good. وهكذا قول أهل العلم من أهل السنة. وأما الجهمية, as for the جهمية, فأنكرت هذه الروايات. The جهمية rejected these narrations. وقالوا, they said, هذا تشبيه. The جهمية, what did they say? When you say Allah has a hand that befits His Majesty, they said, oh, this is تشبيه. Brothers, I ask you, بالله عليكم, who says that today? الشاعر يقولون هذا. The شاعر say that today. The ماتريدية say that today. What did they say to you? When you say Allah has a hand that befits His Majesty, I'm going to affirm it for Him. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He comes down, na'am, He does, in a way that befits His Majesty, subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did they say to you? هذا تشبيه. That's what they say. وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى فِي غَيْرِ مَوْضِعٍ مِنْ كِتَابِهِ الْيَدَى. And in more than one place, Allah mentions in the Quran, He says, Imam al-Tirmidhi saying this, He mentions what? Al-yada, hand. وَالسَّمْعَ, hearing. وَالْبَصَرَ, seeing. فتأولت الجهمية. The جهمية gave it a تأويل. والله the أشاعرة gave the same تأويل. This is exactly the same تأويل they gave it. هذه الآيات وفسروها على غير ما فسر أهل العلم. And they explained it and they distorted it. They distorted it. Because the تأويل here is distortion. They distorted it. The جهمية. These verses and these أحاديث. And they distorted it to what? على غير ما فسر أهل العلم. Not in the way أهل العلم and أهل السنة. أهل العلم here means أهل السنة والجماعة. وقالوا, and they said, إن الله لم يخلق آدم بيدي. They said Allah did not create Adam with His hand. وقالوا, they also said, إنما معنى اليد ها هنا القوة. They said the hand here means what? قوة. The جهمية are the ones who say that Allah's hand is a قوة, right? Who says it, my beloved brothers and sisters? The ones who say that the hand is a قوة are جهمية. So the أشاعر of today are جهمية. They are Jahmis. Because they fell into the tafsir al-Jahmiyin, the tafsir of the Jahmis. Now he brings the call of Ishaq ibn Rahuya, who then refutes the Mushabbiha. We spoke about the Mu'attila, the one who negate Allah's characteristics and don't want to give it to him. And those who went extreme by saying Allah's characteristics, not only do we affirm it for him, but rather we say his characteristics is like the characteristics of the creation. He refutes it. In simple terms, this is what Ishaq ibn Rahuya is saying. Ishaq ibn Ibrahim, he brings. Ishaq ibn Rahuya is him. And that is, are you listening? And that is, when you affirm the characteristics, you can't say, like the characteristics of so-and-so. You can't also say, you can't say, Allah has the characteristics like so-and-so. He says, are you with me? So you can't use the word myth, and you can't use the word kaf. Allah has yadun kayadi. I'm a kayadim, like a hand. You can't. But if the person says, he says, وَأَمَّا إِذَا قَالَ كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ. If the person says, يَدٌ, Allah has a hand. وَسَمْعٌ, and Allah hears. وَبَصَرٌ, and Allah sees. Just leaves it like that. وَلَا يَقُولُ كَيْفَ. And he doesn't give a how by not saying مِثْل. You know, كَاف. He doesn't bring those letters. Are you there, brothers? فَهَذَا لَا. And he says, وَلَا يَقُولُ مِثْلَ سَمْعٍ وَلَا كَسَمْعٍ. فَهَذَا لَا يَكُونُ تَشْبِيهًا. That's not تَشْبِيهًا. وهو كما قال الله تعالى الناس in accordance to the verse of Allah ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع السميع البصير. Because laysa kamithli shay'un is refuting the first group of people. Who are they? The mushabbiha. And then wahuwa sami'ul basiri is refuting the mu'attila. So the path that's safe is the path of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. And that is what? That we affirm the characteristics for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in a way that befits His Majesty subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi. Is Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi a mushabbih? Is Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi, is he a mushabbih? Is he a mujassim by giving Allah and affirming for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala at hand? And you know what's actually amazing is that Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi rahimahullah, he actually places yad, sam'an, basar together. You know why? Because when it comes to believing all of them, they are the same. As for the Asha'ira, they'll say, oh, yeah, I affirm sam'an, basar. Al-yad, it's a jariha. It's a limb. I don't affirm a limb for Allah, tabarak wa ta'ala. That's what they'll say. Who told you it's a limb? Who said it's not a limb? Who said, why are you bringing the word limb in? This kalima jariha is ghariba. It's not ula fil Qur'an, wala fil sunnah. Are you with me, brothers? But the reality of the mu'attila is truly the truth and the reality of their situation is that they are the mushabbiha and they are mu'attila. Are you with me, brothers? The person who does ta'atil, are you with me, and negates Allah's characteristics, what you need to remember is that he's actually a what? He's a mushabbih. How is he a mushabbih? As the poet said, رَمَتْنِي بِدَائِهَا وَانْسَلَّتْ صح? You threw your illness at me and you ran away, yeah? The truth of the matter is, what they are is what they blame others for. When this characteristic was told to them, Allah has a hand, they done tashbih. And they done whatever the tashbih that came to their mind is what they done ta'atil of. Are you with me? So they're fighting with their own thoughts and they're not fighting with what we're saying. They're not fighting with what we believe. We believe Allah has characteristics that befits His Majesty. We don't give it, we don't distort it by calling it Qudra. Another thing that's, Ikhwani, I want you to ponder on. How are you going to translate, how are you going to define a characteristic with this another characteristic of Allah? Qudra is a characteristic of His already. And then Yad is a characteristic of His. How can Qudra be Yad? So then, what's the significance of using Yad then? Sahih? All of that Al-Imam Ibn Khuzaymah rahimahullah in his Kitab al-Tawheed, he speaks about it, and Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala. We have two more hadith left and we finish this chapter. Ithbatu al-asabi'u lillahi, affirming fingers for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The author goes on to say, Al-Imam al-Darqutni haddathana al-Hassan ibn Ali al-Basri, haddathana Abu al-Rabi' al-Zahrani, haddathana Abu Ma'mar, haddathana Awn ibn Abdullah ibn al-Harith, عن أخيه عبد الله بن الحارث بن نوفل عن أبيه. Now here, عبد الله بن الحارث عن أخيه عبد الله بن الحارث بن نوفل عن أبيه. The Sheikh is wrong here. عبد الله بن محمد الغنيمان. Something here is not right. So inshallah ta'ala, I want you to all inshallah see it with me. What did he say? حدثنا. Who narrated it? الحسن بن علي البصري. His name is الحسن بن علي البصري ابن زكريا ابن صالح ابن عاصم أبو سعيد العدوي. You can find his biography in تاريخ بغداد. وهو متروك. His narrations are left. قاله الدارقطني. الإمام الدارقطني said that. أبو ربيع الزهراني. His name is سليمان ابن داود العتكي. His ترجمة you can find in تهذيب. Abu Ma'mar, his name is Ismail ibn Ibrahim ibn Ma'mar, Abu Ma'mar al-Qutay'i al-Harawiyu, his tarjama is in Tahdib. Are you there? Awn ibn Abdillahi. His tarjama, there's not a place to find it. I looked for it, I couldn't find it. The author here says something. Look what he says. Are you with me, brothers? Al-Sheikh Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman is wrong in here. The sanad, the way he brings it. It's meant to be حَدَّثَنَا الْحَسَّنِ ibn Ali al-Basriyu. حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو الرَّبِيعَ الزَّهْرَانِيُ. حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو مَعْمَرَ. حَدَّثَنَا عَوْن ibn عَبْدِ اللَّهِ ibn الْحَارِثِ. It's not عَوْن ibn عَبْدِ اللَّهِ ibn الْحَارِثِ. It's Aoun, sorry. حدثنا Aoun ibn Abdullah ibn al-Harith, صح? He narrated it from who? an akhihi, his brother. You know who his brother is? His brother is Abdullah ibn Abdullah. صح? Because if it's own ibn Abdullah, his brother has to be what? Something Abdullah, right? It has to be something and then ibn Abdullah, right? So his brother is Abdullah ibn Abdullah. Naam. He's thiqatun min rijali tahdib, his brother. Are you there? And their father is going to be who? The both of them, their father is Abdullah ibn al-Harith ibn al-Awfal. Are you there, brothers? So the one who narrated from the Prophet, are you there? Or else, what would it have been is that the one who narrated from the Prophet would have been al-Harith ibn al-Awfal, based on Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunaymas Taba'a. Are you there? But in reality, the one who narrated from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is Abdullah ibn al-Harith ibn al-Awfal. Are you there? And he's a tabi'i. So this hadith, and he's not a sahabi. So if a tabi'i narrates and attributes a narration to the Prophet directly, what is it called? Mursal. It's a mursal. So this narration is mursal. قال Rasulullah, he said that the Prophet said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ خَلَقَ ثَلَاثَةَ أَشْيَاءٍ بِيَدِهِ. Allah created three things with his hand. خَلَقَ آدَمَ بِيَدِهِ. Allah created Adam with what? Allah created Adam with his hand. وَكَتَّبَ التَّوْرَاةَ بِيَدِي. And Allah wrote the Torah with his hand. وَغَرَسَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ بِيَدِي. And Allah planted the... وَغَرَسَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ بِيَدِهِ with his own hand. Allah تبارك وتعالى. Are you with me, brothers? So, this hadith is... as Imam al-Bayhaqi mentions, is mursal. It's mursal. But the hadith has shawahid and mutaba'at that strengthen it. If you go to the kitab, kitab al-sunnah by Abu Qasim, Hibatullahi al-Lalaka'iyu. Are you with me? شرح أصول اعتقاد أهل السنة والجماعة. He brings many other طرق and many other روايات to strengthen the authenticity of this narration. Then the author brings the last hadith for this chapter, which is حدثنا الحسين بن إسماعيل حدثنا يوسف بن موسى حدثنا أبو عبد الرحمن المقرئ حدثنا حيوة بن شريح أخبرني أبو هاني أنه سمع أبا عبد الرحمن. The author, what does he say? طبعا عبد الله بن محمد الغنيمان. He says أنه سمع أبا عبد الرحمن أيه الحبري, right? It's wrong. It's meant to be حبولي. There's a ياء. There's meant to be a ياء that's missing from there. So the شيخ did a mistake. There's a خطأ here. His name is what? حبولي with a ياء. نعم. So who is Al-Husayn ibn Ismail? We spoke about it when we were on the 20th hadith. حدثنا يوسف ibn Musa. يوسف ibn Musa ibn Rashid. صدوق من رجال تهذيب. حدثنا أبو عبد الرحمن المقري. Some of the طبعات they say أبو عبد الله المقري. That's incorrect. It's meant to be أبو عبد الرحمن المقري. That's correct. عبد الله ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman. He got that one right. And his name is عبد الله ibn Yazid. ثقة من رجال تهذيب. He says, قال حدثنا... He says, حدثنا حيوة بن شريح. حيوة بن شريح is a ثقة من رجال تهذيب. And he says, أخبرني أبو هاني. His name is حميد بن هاني الخولاني المصري. لا بأس به. There's no problem with him. There's no problem. No problem with him. أنه سمع that he heard عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص يقول saying. He had Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As saying that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqulu innahu sami'a, that he heard the Prophet of Allah saying qulubu bani adama kulluha bayna usbu'ayn min asabi'i ar-rahmani 'azza wa jalla ka qalbin wahidin yasrifuha kayfa yasha, that the hearts of the children of Adam, all of them, are between two fingers of the fingers of Allah, ka qalbin wahidin, like one heart, yasrifuha, Allah turns it subhanahu wa ta'ala kayfa yasha, as he wishes. ثم قال رسول الله, and then the messenger said, اللهم مسرف القلوب, oh Allah, the one who turns the hearts, اصرف قُلُوبَنَا عَلَى طَاعَتِكَ. Divert our hearts and turn our hearts towards your obedience. So this hadith shows that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He has two fingers. قُلُوبُ بَنِي آدَمَ كُلُّهَا بَيْنَ أُصْبُعَيْنِ. Two fingers. مِنْ أَصَابِعِ الرَّحْمَنِ. From the fingers of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. So this narration tells us that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has fingers. Are you there? And the hearts of the creation are between His fingers, subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَصْرِفُهَا كَيْفَ يَشَاءَ. Allah turns them as He wishes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah turns them as He wishes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. My beloved brothers and sisters, this narration is very well known from the tariqah of who? Abu Abdul Rahman al-Muqri, whose name I mentioned before is Abdullah ibn Yazid. He's thiqah min rijali tahdib. Are you there, brothers? And many people narrated from him. Many people have narrated it from him. Are you there? Who narrated it from here? Yusuf ibn Musa ibn Rashid. Sudduq min rijali tahdib is the one who narrated from him right now. Are you there? Yusuf ibn Musa ibn Rashid. Also, Imam Ahmad, there are other 14 other narrators that narrated from him. And I'll mention them quickly. Imam Ahmad narrated from him, as he's in his Musnad. Also, Abu Khaythamah Zuhair ibn Harbin, he also narrated from him. Ibn Numayr also narrated from him. So Imam Ahmad's one you can find in his Musnad. As for Zuhair ibn Harbin and Ibn Numayr, you can find his one in Sahih Muslim. Also, Ubaydullah ibn Abdullah ibn Yazid, which is his son. And Imam al-Nasa'i brings it in his Sunan al-Kubra. Salamat ibn Shabib al-Bazzar brings it in his Musnad. Ali ibn Ma'bad ibn Abdul Barr brings it in his Tamheed. Muhammad ibn Musaffa ibn Abi Asim brings it in Kitab al-Sunnah. Suwaid, al-Imam al-Nasa'i brings it in his Kubra. Muhammad ibn Abdullah ibn al-Hakam, Kharajahu al-Ghazwini in his Tadween. Al-Harith ibn Muhammad al-Tamimi ibn Battah brings it in Kitab al-Ibana. And also Bayhaqi in Kitab al-Asma'i wa Sifat. Ahmad ibn Umar al-Waki'i ibn Battah brings it in his Kitab al-Ibana. Al-Walid ibn Muslim ibn Khuzaymah brings it in Kitab al-Tawheed. Zuhair ibn Muhammad al-Maruzi, al-Imam al-Ajurri brings it in Kitab al-Sharia. So Yahya ibn Abdik al-Ghazwini, al-Imam al-Ajurri brings it in Kitab al-Sharia. Now we saw 14 narrators who have narrated all from who? Abdullah ibn Yazid. Abu Abdul Rahman al-Muqri. Okay? But Abdul Rahman ibn Yazid, Abu Abdul Rahman al-Muqri, he has a tubi'a alayhi. He's got a mutaba'a. Somebody else narrated it with him. And is who? None other than Abdullah ibn Mubarak. Abdi ibn Humayt, he brings it in his Muntakab. Both of them. Abdullah ibn Yazid. Are you there, brothers? Abdullah ibn Yazid, whose name is Abu Abdul Rahman al-Muqri. And Abdullah ibn Mubarak, both of them narrated from who? Haywa ibn Shuraik. Haywa ibn Shuraik, right? They both narrated an Abi Hani and Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As marfu'an. We've also learned the mutaba'a that Abdullah ibn Yazid has, rahimahullah ta'ala. And who's the mutaba'a for him? Abdullah ibn Mubarak, right? Also, Haywa ibn Shariih, ibn Shuraih. Haywa ibn Shuraih, right? Who did Abdullah ibn Mubarak, Abdullah ibn Yazid narrate from? Haywa ibn Shuraih, right? Haywa ibn Shuraih also has a mutaba'a. He has a mutaba'a from Rashdeen ibn Sa'ad. Imam Ahmad brings it in his Musnad. And Rashdeen ibn Sa'ad, are you there? The famous hadith in Bulugh al-Maram, إِذَا بَلَغَ الْمَاءُ قُلَّتَيْنِ لَمْ يَحْمِلُ الْخُبْثُ, right? If the water reaches Qullatayn, it's weakened because of him, Rashdeen ibn Sa'ad. They weakened it because of him. But he's a mutaba'a for Haywa ibn Shuraih. And also, these are mutaba'at that I mentioned now. The hadith has also got shawahid, many shawahid, some which are sahih, some which are da'if. From the shawahid that they have is a narration from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Al-Imam al-Nasa'i narrated in his Kubra. Also he narrated himself, Al-Imam al-Nasa'i, in Amal al-Yawmi wal-Layla. Ahmad narrated in his Musnad, Abu Ya'la in his Musnad, Abdullah ibn Humayd in his Muntakab, Ibn Adi in his Kamil. All of them, min tariq Abi Salamah al-Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, Abi Salamah did not reach Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. And if he did, then an alayh is what he narrated it with. The isnad is weak. Ala kulli hal, the first one is Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. The second one is Umm Salama. Tirmidhi narrated Ibn Jarir in his Tafsir, Ibn Abi Shayba in his Musannaf, Ishaq ibn Rahuwi in his Musnad, Ahmad in his Musnad, Tayalisi in his Musnad, Tabarani in his Awsat, and his Kabir, Abu Ya'la in his Musnad, Abdi ibn Humayd in his Muntakhab, Tabarani in his Kabir, or Ibn Abi Asim in his Sunnah. Also, Hadith Abi Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu narrated it. Ibn Khuzayma brings the Kitab al-Tawheed. Also, Hadith Nu'aym ibn Hammam. Sorry. Nu'aym ibn Hammar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Ibn Abi Asim in his Kitab al-Sunnah, he brings it. At-Tabarani in his Musnad al-Shamiyyin. Also, Hadith Ubadah ibn Samit. Ibn Adi brings in Kitab al-Kamil. He's also a shahid for this narration. Abdurrahman ibn Yazid ibn Amir, also he's a shahid. You can find his one. Abu al-Hajjaj al-Mizzi brings it in his Kitab Tahdhib al-Kamal. Also, Abu Huraira. At-Tabarani brings in his Awsat. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi brings in his Sirah Alami al-Nubala. And he also says, after that, Imam al-Dhahabi says, هذا حديث غريب جدا والمت قد روية من وجوه وهو في صحيح مسلم. And Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله says, this hadith is غريب جدا in this particular way. But the matan is, it's been narrated in many different wujuh, many different turuq, many different narrations. And it's in Sahih Muslim originally. Last but not least is Hadith al-Sabrah ibn Fatik al-Asadi. He's one of al-Tabarani narrated in his Musnad al-Shamiyyin, Ibn Abi Asim in his Ahad wal-Mathani, al-Sunnah also, Ibn Abi Asim. And this is also Isnadul Hasan la ba'sa bihi. This one is a chain which is Hasan la ba'sa bihi. So we have we have 8 shawahid for this particular hadith. And if we add this hadith to it, we have how many in total? We have 9 sahabi, 9 different companions who've actually narrated this particular narration. So hadith, haqiqatan, it's a hadith which is strong and no one can disagree with. And you find these narrations in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim. The hadith is aslan in Sahih Bukhari and Muslim. So inshallah ta'ala, we finished the chapter of Ithbatu al-Asabi'u lillahi ta'ala, affirming a finger for Allah tabarak ta'ala, or fingers for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Next lesson inshallah ta'ala, we're going to go into Ithbatu al-Dhahiki lillahi ta'ala, affirming laugh for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فإنه مني ومن الشيطان والله ورسوله بريئان منه سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.